Hello, let us solve this question. The students of a class are made to stand in a row. If three students are extra in row, there would be one row less. If three students are less in row, there would be two rows more. Find the number of students in the class. So I will explain this with the small example. So let us say I have three rows, row 1, row 2 and row 3. I have three rows and you can see each row has four students, isn't it? So if I want to find total number of students, how will I find? Number of rows time number of students in each row, and that will make 12, isn't it? Now this simple example will help you to understand this question. So here let us say number of rows x and student in each row is y. So now I have two important information, number of rows and number of students in each row. So that will make total number of students x, y. So I think you are pretty clear till here. Now if you understood this, the question will be very easy for you. Now let us work on this statement. If three students are extra in row, there would be one row less. So it means three students are added to row. So number of students in each row is y. And if you add 3 to that, then number of rows, this x, number of rows, as question says, there would be one less. It means x minus 1. And whatever the order you change, if I rearrange my dots here in other way, if I take 1 here, 1 here, 1 here, that will not change number of students, isn't it? This will be 4 times 3, so students will be 12 only in any case. So in our case, total students will be x, y. Now I will simplify this, so this will be y times x, so I will write x, y. You can write y, x also, but I am writing it in alphabetical order, x, y. Then this will be y times 1, that is minus y. 3 times x, 3 times x, 3x, and 3 times 1, that is minus 3, is equals to xy. Now if I take this xy to the another side, xy, xy will be cancelled. So what I am left with? I am left with 3x, I am just rearranging it, 3x minus y, and if I take this minus 3 to the another side, that will be positive 3. This is my equation number 1. Now let us work on second statement. If 3 students are less in a row, it means if you decrease number of students in each row. So here we have y number of students in each row and I will decrease it by 3. So y minus 3. There will be 2 rows more. So that will be x plus 2, because number of rows are x and 2 added, x plus 2 is equals to again xy. As I explained earlier, number of students will not change. Now y times x, so that is xy. Y times 2, that is 2y. Minus 3 times x, that is minus 3x. Minus 3 times 2 minus 6 is equals to xy. Now same way we did in equation 1, here also xy, xy will be cancelled. If I take this xy this side, that will be minus. So I am left with minus 3x. I am just rewriting in correct order. Actually this is also correct order, but I am just rewriting it in the good format of x and y. Minus 3x plus 2y is equals to 6. So this is my equation 2. And now I will copy equation 1 also here, that is 3x minus y is equals to 3, and I will solve it by elimination method. So here you can see 3x, 3x can be cancelled. Generally we change the sign, but here we will not change because we can easily cancel it out. If we cannot cancel, in that case we change the sign. Plus 2y minus y is y, and 6 plus 3 is 9. So my answer for y is 9. Now I want to find answer for x. So for that I will substitute this value over here. So instead of y I will write 9. So this will be 3x minus 9 is equals to 3. Now 3x is equals to, if I take this minus 9 this side, this will be plus 9. So 3 plus 9, 12. And x is equals to 12 divided by 3, 4. So my answer is 9 and 4. So I hope you find it useful. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to press the like button. Thank you.